Yo, what's poppin'? You done tap back in with the Gangsta's Kitchen in the Hood, where the food is vegan and you would not get tired of eating. I promise. I mean, hey, you cooking with a blood. What's poppin'? So check this right today. I'm finna show you how I made a barbecue pulled pork wrap, right? With some vegan coleslaw. So boom, first thing first, I'm gonna show you how I made the coleslaw, right? The vegan coleslaw. So the first thing I like to do with my cabbage is peel like the first layer, and then I cut like a little piece, and I did the same thing with the purple cabbage. I got green cabbage and purple cabbage for the vegan coleslaw. And then what I did was I grabbed my handheld shredder, you know, and I shred them guys down, you know, not too thick, but you know, you want it right. You want them little shreds like coleslaw. And now I got a purple carrot, you know, I bust that down like this here. You know, and now I threw it in a bowl. I'm sure you wondering why I got it in there. And that's because I clean everything. I clean my vegetables. I got some apple cider vinegar, right? And I also got some sea salt, right? And then, you know, you bust that down, let it soak for a little minute. And then you some warm water. So, boom, after I clean that, transfer it in a new bowl. Now I got some soy-free vegan mayo. Now, y'all know, man, look, this the Gangsta Kitchen. We don't do too much measuring going on. So, boom, I just threw the mayonnaise in there until it looked right. So, I grabbed, like, about 2.5 little spoons. I also got some organic white wine vinegar. You just want a couple swigs of this, you know, because it's going to be super strong. You know, don't too much, you know what I'm saying? Just a couple of, yeah. And now I also got some 100% pure avocado oil, just a little bit. And then I got some lemon juice. It's pretty hard squeezing this guy up out of there, but, you know, I made that guy happen. So, just a half a lemon. Now we're going to season a little bit. I got some Old Bay seasoning, some black pepper. You want to be generous with the black pepper. Not too much, though, but, you know, be a little generous. I also got some pink Himalayan sea salt. You know, we got to get the minerals in, baby. Yeah, you know what's happening. And now we're going to mix this on in and let it get right, let it get tight. And this is what it's going to look right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, mine was a tad bit watery because of the lemon juice. I had put a lot of lemon juice in there, not too much. And then, of course, it's going to turn a little purplish pinkish because that's because of the cabbage. But, yeah, you know. So, boom, we're going to throw that in the refrigerator. Let that cool off. Let that cool down. Let that get cold. Now, I got some organic jackfruit. So, boom, we're going to get a nice little skillet with some a little avocado oil. And we're going to get it right. First thing first that's going to go up in that pot is a little onion. For those who don't know, you want to keep one end of the onion on the other end, and then you ain't going to be crying and sniffing and all that good stuff. You know, I learned that off of one of the little videos, you know, on the back end. But, boom, we're going to throw this in the pot, let that get right. And now we're going to get this organic jackfruit. It's really good, I'm telling you. You know, it's sweet. Yeah, so it's in the brine. I got the jackfruit in the brine. But what I did was, of course, I poured the water out. We don't want to... You know, we don't want too much water. And then I just emptied it out in this little pan so y'all could see what it looked like. Now, what I did try to do was I attempted to try to shred them. But the fact that they was, like, pretty cold and it was pretty hard. So what I did was I just went ahead and transferred it in a pot. You know, I let it get hot, let it get warm, you know, and soften up a little bit. And then, you know, yeah, it'll be able to shred because what it's going to do is... The jackfruit gonna shred like real pulled pork. It's brazy. I promise you. Just please keep watching, baby. Please. I got watched it. So, boom. You see? It looked like pork. Now, I'm still doing a little shredding, you know, right now. But you see how it looked like pulled pork? It's brazy, but it's amazing. Like, it's amazing. Especially when you start seasoning that motherfucker. Hey, baby. Boo, we're gonna bust these bell peppers down. You feel me? Yeah, boo. So, we're gonna bust the bell peppers down. And now everything, you know, cooked down. Hey, look, shout out to Rib Rack Barbecue Rub, but they sent me a whole box of seasonings. I don't know what the hell I'm going to do with them, but, yeah, shout out to them. So I got some onion powder, some basil, garlic powder, black pepper, some pink Himalayan sea salt. We're going to bust that down like this here with the seasoning. And now we're going to go on with the sauce. I got some barbecue sauce, but, you know, we do a lot. So we're going to do the barbecue sauce, yellow mustard, some ketchup, some liquid smoke hickory, and some coconut aminos with a little agave. Oh, yeah, baby. Hey, boy, I be going crazy. So, look, I chose not to use bread, right, because, of course, I'm doing the wrap, right? So, with this wrap, I'm using a collar wrap. I'm going to show you how I bust this down. So, unfortunately, you can't see it, but what I'm doing is I'm cutting that long stem off. And then I'm, like, splitting that stem a little bit so it can be skinny. like that. And the reason being is so it can, you know, it won't be a hard crunch. It can rap, you know, rap easily. And also, this is also aided into the rap easily when you put in some boiling water for like no longer than 30 seconds. No longer than that. But see how flimsy it is? Now it's going to be, you know, yeah, it's going to be easy to rap. So, boom. We're going to bust this down, fill this guy up, put in the barbecue jack, the barbecue pulled pork with the cabbage. I mean, the coleslaw. And now I got some organic pico I had got from Whole Foods. I love tomatoes, so you know I had put like a little double back on that. And what we're gonna do with this guacamole is throw that motherfucker on the side, cause I want that on the side. I don't want that gone. But yeah, you know, excuse my language, please forgive me, queen. But forgive me, queen, kings and queens. But yeah, so boom, I also got some carrot chips back there, some salsa, some guac. You know, yeah. So this is what it look like. This is my plate, man. You know how I do it, yeah. So yeah, this is the vegan pulled pork. I showed y'all how I made the vegan coleslaw. Yeah, now it's time to bust down. Look, I appreciate y'all for tapping in with me. Cooking with the blood. I get